All right, are you buying or selling your house? So many are. And if so, you really want to make sure you have the right person representing it. So, lifestyle correspondent with a license to sell, real estate license to sell, Mar Jennings is here to talk about the right questions to ask before you hire a realtor. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
So great to have you back.
Great to be back.
Well, you've been busy because you're still, of course, the lifestyle expert, but you're also using that expertise to sell a house.
Yes.
And what a difference it makes. It's a tough market.
Totally. And I've been in the business now for 2.5 years. And one thing that I've noticed is that I've taken that lifestyle approach and infused it into the real estate business. And it's created really fantastic results. Mm-hmm. And what I've learned is that there's a lot of people that do things the way realtors do things.
Yes.
But there's also another side of questions that you should ask and things you should do that are not in a traditional manner. Now, what I'm going to say to you is today is 5 questions that you'd be crazy not to ask your realtor.
But your realtor really doesn't want you to ask.
But they do not want you to ask right. those questions, okay?
We're here for you, the viewers.
That's
so
right,
we're
exactly.
All ears.
The first one is ask them, what do they like about real estate?
Well, that's interesting.
People will say, oh, the flexibility, I can take care of my kids, I have a lot of convenience when it comes to it. Those are nice answers, but what you're looking for someone to say, I'm a salesperson.
Mm.
I love the sales component because there's negotiating, there's representing yourself. It really is a proactive, not a reactive approach to selling a home. So you really want them to say, I'm a salesperson.
Because when you're selling your home or buying a home, you really want to be the star of that realtor show, don't you? You want to feel like they're giving everything they got because it's a big decision. It's a big
Absolutely.
Purchase or sale. Yeah.
They're a salesperson, so
right.
you want them to sell. And if they're listing your house, they're still selling your house.
That's right.
Okay?
Okay.
Number two,
here we go.
What is your social media presence?
Interesting. When I saw that, I thought, wow, I think a lot of realtors don't really have much of one.
You know, they use it, they show their kids, they show the ball games, they're using it, and that's fine. But you really should have, especially if you're a realtor, you should have a presence that's connecting you to other brokers in other states as well. Because we always love to get the New York buyer. We love to get the New Jersey buyer, the Massachusetts buyer mm-hmm. in Connecticut. So you want to connect with those people outside your market share, as well as using it as a platform to really promote the listing, the open houses, the creativeness that you are doing to bring a house up. And that's the idea. You want to get the visibility. World Wide Web, use the world as your platform.
Have you sold houses on social media?
Immediately.
Oh,
I get
okay.
a lot of good clients from my social media platform. And I'm talking LinkedIn, I'm talking Facebook,
yeah,
Twitter, all of them.
All
you got to really get out
everywhere.
There. Everywhere. Okay. The next one, how do you describe your home? This is the big one. Nice yard, 3 bedroom, 2.5 baths. You got to make it stand. Tell the story. Identify what is the house all about. And ask for a writing sample.
Can I tell you what drives me crazy? Typos.
Oh!
Typos are too many acronyms or abbreviations where you're like, I don't even know what language this is.
Top 10 words that are spelled incorrectly,
yes.
you know, cul-de-sac.
If you're describing a small house as cozy and whatever, that's great.
Right.
But it instantly makes me think, that's small, really
exactly.
small.
Exactly.
You know,
so be careful.
And, yeah.
and you want to make sure that when you ask them for that writing sample, one, that there is a spell check done because you see a lot of mistakes on there. But most importantly, you want to see how they're going to represent the house mm-hmm. in a writing fashion because a lot of it is communicating through text. And through email.
In our last minute, let's do 4 and 5.
Yeah, okay, so it is, this is a big one. How many clients do you have? Because if you have 10, 15 clients and you're one person, it's impossible for that person to handle all of it.
Okay.
So you need a team.
You're,
so
yeah.
keep that in mind. Just because they have a lot of listing doesn't mean that they're the one that's gonna sell your house quickly. And number 5, this is a big one. Oh my goodness. Do you use a lockbox?
Oh, yeah. We've been just talking about
yeah.
this.
Yeah, houses yeah. don't sell themselves. And I've gotten a lot of criticism in reference to not using a lockbox by other realtors because they say, oh, well, they want privacy. They want to walk through the house. You know, it's more convenient. Yes, all true. But I have never, ever found a client say to me that they're not upset with me being there because I want to describe the house, show the possibility, answer any questions that they possibly need.
You know the house better than their realtor does.
Exactly.
Right?
And if they need that privacy, I will step away. But I'm really, again, it goes back to selling the house.
Mm-hmm.
And it's more work on my part because I have to be available when they call. They want to see the house, I'm there. So it is one of those things that most realtors just put a lockbox and say, yeah, go see it, you know, give an hour notice. But no, I'm there. I represent the house. I'm selling it. I'm going to sell it for
you. How many people are listening right now? They're on the phone
to
the realtor. You know that?
Operators are standing by.
Mar Jennings, thank you so much. You can get more tips at marjennings.com.
Absolutely.
Thank you so much.
My pleasure.
All right. We're also watching.